Good evening everyone, this is Jishnu from Pantech Solution. Today we are going to see regarding towards wireless body area network. Thanks to KSRM College of Engineering, Department of Electronics and Communication for providing this wonderful opportunity in order to conduct this particular webinar. I hope that everyone is audible. So today's session completely we are going to see regarding towards the wireless body area networks. So we will be having a small intro regarding towards the embedded system. So from that embedded system, what will be that wireless body area networks and wireless communications, what and all interface towards the embedded system. So what will be the application? So regarding towards that application, you'll be seeing a small application with the help of NodeMCU, like how to send the data from the controller towards the mobile. So once again, I welcome you all for this webinar, Wireless Body Area Networks. Let us start the session. Pantech has been originated in the year of 2004. We have 7 branches and 100 plus employees. We have conducted more than 1,200 workshops. We also have taught more than 100 plus webinars. We have our own R&D for industrial projects. We also conduct faculty development programs, hands-on training workshops, internships and in-plant trainings, short-term courses, value-added courses, academic project training, customized design services at the state of R&D. We have been expertised in the area of Internet of Things, Artificial Intelligence, Embedded System or Robotics, VLSI FPGA TMS Processor, Image Processing using OpenCV and Network Simulation, Powertronics, Electric Vehicle, Big Data, Data Analytics, Internet of Things, Python, Android Application Development, Data Image Text Mining, Cloud Computing and Mobile Computing. So intro towards an embedded system. So why here embedded system is playing a major role? Whatever you are thinking, it is nothing but it is in the right way. So this wireless body area networks, definitely the body area networks is completely related towards some part of the embedded system, which is able to communicate wirelessly with the help of some kind of sensors to analyze the body temperature, pressure, or we can also the pressure in the sense, the blood pressure or the heartbeat or their walking distance in the form of steps. So this complete systems has been designed with the help of embedded, and generally the communication only is done through the wireless system. So here embedded plays a major role, where embedded is nothing but known as the microprocessor based computer hardware system, which contains even controller as well as the processor, where the processor or the controller is used to read a particular kind of real-time data from the real-time sensors, and it will be used to convey this particular message to any other device through any other mode of communication. So here two interfaces, whatever we are doing, those are nothing but wireless communication as well as the embedded system. So this wireless communication implementing towards the embedded system only will play a major role of sending and receiving the data over there. So for this embedded system, we have to know some basic languages and the tools. Even we also should be aware of serial communication protocols. So with the help of that particular serial communication protocols only, we will be able to send and receive the data. So what are the hardwares we currently used for it? So generally, if you just call regarding towards the hardwares, Raspberry Pi, Nord MCU, Arduino, Intel Edison, BeagleBone, and Arduino BLE. So these all the hardwares we will be mostly using it for this particular purpose. So you might be thinking how it is possible with multiple communications. Each and every controller has a maximum capacity to work with Internet of Things. So other than Internet of Things, what and all the communication can be added over here? Those are radio frequency, known as RF, Bluetooth, LoRa, Zigbee. So these type of communication can be easily implemented with this kind of embedded systems. So therefore, according to the application, whatever we use, we will be providing it as an product. The wireless body area network. The V-band or wireless body area network, it is used to communicate between the particular human body as well as the electronic system in order to measure all the parameters of our body. So this particular network system is similar to the industrial section only. In what way? In the sense, especially if you go for the industry, they will be keeping some amount of sensors in front of any of the conveyors or boiler, and those sensor values will be recorded with the help of system in a control room. So this particular technique or this particular applicant only we have been shifted towards the body area networks. This body area networks plays a major role in human body, and at the same time they can also be implemented for the animal body. This contains the complete section of sensors whatever we require. So this sensors, in the sense, measuring the heartbeat, pulse, measuring the oxygen, which is known as pulse oximeter, and even the calories, how many we have burned and how many of amount of calories are present in our body, number of food steps whatever we have kept during that particular day, and how many hours we have slept normally. So this common kind of things can be easily read with the help of the sensors, and this sensor value we will be recording it with the help of some embedded system, and using the wireless communication tools we will be able to send that particular data from one place to another place. Even if you are using this as an IoT oriented function, therefore we will be able to store it in the cloud. So what and all the common kind of functions like heart rate, blood pressure, brain signals, etc. So this particular heart rate, blood pressure and brain sense, we will be mostly commonly used for multiple analysis. Even with the help of BP itself, we will be able to calculate n number of systems. Even nowadays, you might have seen some kind of devices like AccuCheck. So this is also one kind of wireless body area network only, where there won't be any communication, but with the help of that particular device, we will be able to measure the complete sugar level or whatever the oxygen content which is present with the help of the sensor over there. So similarly, if you use some other the real-time functions like smartwatches. So with the help of smartwatch or the Fitband, commonly it is known as the Fitband system. So that particular Fitband, whenever we tie it towards our wrist, it is able to get that particular pulse rate. And based on the pulse rate, they will be able to calculate the measure of that particular oxygen. Even that SpO2 sensor is also available. So with the help of that particular SpO2 sensor, they will be able to measure how many percentage of oxygen the person is able to inhale. So whenever we connect all the system with the help of some of the communications, external communication system, to send the data or to record the data, for that particular system only we will be commonly saying as wireless body area networks. So within this particular image itself, we will be able to see. So within that particular person, the multiple sensors are being connected. Using that particular Zigbee as a communication method, they are transmitting the data towards the hardware or their particular device. And from that device, using the GPRS, Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, they are able to share the particular data towards the cloud. And from that cloud, if there is any requirement. So some part of data is sent for the weather forecast, then for emergency in hospitals, then if there is any person known as the caregiver, and at the same time the medical server or the physician. So they will be able to monitor that particular person's record in and out time. So previously how this was done, if you go to the hospital, definitely they will be taking us for the pre-analysis, like weight checking, temperature, and especially if you go for some sort of heart oriented checkup, they will be making you to walk on that particular treadmill. So to check that particular person's whether how much speed he is able to walk with the help of that particular ECG sensors, and these sensor data will be recorded towards their particular graph value, and it will also be stored in that computer whichever they use. Now this particular wired system has been converted into the wireless. So what are the different types of wireless band area network, body area network? Those are nothing but in-body communication and out-body communication. So generally, what is that particular in-body or out-body, if ever we speak over there? Those are completely known as the what and all the sensors that has been activated inside our body. So that particular system normally is said as in-body communication, and on-body, whatever the sensors which you have fixed on our body. So for example, we can say that Fitband itself or the smartwatch, or there are many more sensors which will be able to measure the complete data of our human body. So that's a particular sensors, if you are just fixing in our hand, therefore it will be able to just record the complete data. So which is fixed on the body, those kind of communication devices are known as on-body communication. Generally, if we go for this two different types, in-body type of communication are rarely used and rarely seen. And one of the example for this particular in-body communication, it is nothing but the pill cam. So here you can see that particular image over there. And this particular pill cam, it is completely used for taking an endoscopy images within our particular internal system. So like the food pipe, or we can go with our stomach. So therefore, even it can also take the photos of the large intestine, small intestine. So through which and all it is able to travel, it will be able to collect it. And based on that particular communication, mostly they will be using the Bluetooth type of communication. So that will be connected towards the system of the doctor, and they will be able to snap the particular images. And based on that particular snapping of images, they will be able to analyze what is the current situation of the patient to whom that particular pill cam has been provided. Whereas the on-body communication, like the example whatever I have said for this smartwatch or that Fitband, so normally we can say it as a pacemaker. So pacemaker is nothing but it is a kind of artificial heart which is fixed on a person. So this particular pacemaker readings and recordings can be easily taken with the help of the bandwidth. So based on that particular band, they will be able to record each and every kind of data, whatever we able to acquire it or store it over there. So how the parts of a particular pill cam can be enabled over there? So this parts of pill cam, what and all available in the sense, the image sensor and CPU, that is the most important thing. Then electromagnet, permanent magnet, white LED, fluorescent LED, inner capsule and outer capsule. So what are this each and every functions over there? The permanent magnet is completely known for just to rotate the particular camera in different directions. Electromagnet will be providing the fluctuation oriented power supplies for minimal period. Then white LEDs are used as a flashlights. So since the internal part of our body is completely in the dark, so to take the particular photographs little bit brighter, they are using this fluorescent LEDs and white LEDs. The inner capsule stands for the inner part of the particular capsule, which takes a major kind of processing in between it. And similarly, if you use that outer capsule, it is a covering body which is edible as well as digestible for the particular patient. So the CPU and the image sensor. So whenever it starts to function within our inside the body, therefore the CPU process will enable the image sensor to take the snaps, whereas this camera is able to rotate in 360 degree. So with that particular 360 degree direction, it will be snapping all the images. So according to the images whichever we require, therefore we can take it as a finalized and analyzed report over from the doctor. So normally whatever the scanning whichever we are doing, it is nothing but CT scan, MRI scan and MMRI scan. So if that is also a little bit difficult, and if you want to just check it as an internal, therefore we have to apply this kind of function. Whereas the wired camera also are available, which is mostly used for endoscopy whenever they are removing the blocks of the heart or the blood clotting within the particular person's body, which they will be inserting that particular camera through the food pipe. Whatever you see through the camera, it will be looking like an animated only, but it won't, because it is the exact kind of images whatever we are able to see, and with the help of that endoscopy only they will be able to remove the clots or whatever the blocks that are being in the blood vessels. So similar to that kind of material only, this particular pill cam, which works in the wireless format. Even live video streaming option also is available in pill cam. So if you have any doubt in this particular kind of functions, you can just put it in the chat box. How pill cam can be removed from the inner organ due to wireless? Yeah, this particular system is digestible and edible. That's why only I have said it in the starting. So once the particular function gets over, it automatically gets digested from the human waste. Whatever the motor that has been fixed inside that particular some of the pill cams, those are normal kind of servo motors only. That can also be controllable. Even controlling option also is available. So it differs according to the device or the brand whichever we purchase. This is one of the costliest thing only. I'm not sure how much it is. Guys, if you like this particular kind of contents, whatever we provide, please like and share to your friends so that this will be as a free knowledge sharing. We have any other doubts, we can just conclude it. where we can check the sensor data. Yeah, they are providing a separate software which can be installed towards your system. These are commonly set as the biomedical devices with software implementation. So since it is wireless, we have to just install the particular software and we have to enable that communication. Bluetooth means Bluetooth, Wi-Fi means Wi-Fi. So what mode of communication this is, according to that we have to fix it. And by enabling that particular software, you will be able to read the particular data. Yeah, image sensor, it is particularly used for the purpose of taking photographs and streaming live videos. For streaming as well as snapping the particular kind of images only, the processor is being used. I hope everyone's doubt is clear. If you have any doubts, you can just post it in the chat box. Definitely, we'll be clearing out whatever we know regarding towards it. So next, let us step into the wireless communication. I hope everyone is aware of this particular wireless communication. So according to the devices from our childhood, cannot be said as childhood. Yeah, definitely. From my childhood, they have been started to use this kind of wireless communication devices. Like whatever I have seen, those are the walkie talkies. Then there comes with the cordless telephone. Then there comes with mobile phones, and now the smartphones. Now there are many kind of wireless devices, including the laptop or the smartwatch, everything. The parts in the pill does not affect any organs inside the body, not at all. There won't be any kind of damage towards our parts, because the pill will be smaller the size according to, while comparing with our food pipe or any other external connectivities inside our organs. So it will be just flowing regarding towards it. So whenever we flow towards, in the sense, whenever we swallow that particular pill, it is directly going or traveling towards that particular food pipe. So there will be some fluid kind, and through that fluid kind, it will be just floating and moving apart from that. Because there is no much kind of hard systems over there. If your pill outer cover is strong, definitely it is not a kind of damageable device and all. Definitely there will be some radiations regarding towards the wireless communication. That is common. But that is a temporary kind of communication only. So the wireless communication, definitely whatever we see throughout our life, those are mostly set as the mobiles only. So initially it was known as the landline, so which cannot be portable. Then came with battery landline since the cordless phones, so connecting the same landline only, but we in and around of house we can take it and talk. At the same time, it requires some charge. We have to place it over there. Only that is the difference from that. Then comes with the mobile, which can be taken anywhere in the world. And according to the communication, it is very simple. We can also store more number of contacts, and from that we have to select the contacts and we have to call that particular person. So that particular communication starts from GSM, and now it is being upgraded till 5G. So within that also there are lot of difference in communications. Then another kind of communication comes with the internet, where we can see that internet, first and all, we will be using LAN or WAN. So now also we are using the same LAN or WAN with wireless fidelity, known as the Wi-Fi. So according to the Wi-Fi device, whatever we keep, we will be able to cover the maximum range. And from that particular system only, we will be able to see all that wireless oriented system. Now itself, my system is at another place and connection is provided at another place. So through that, it is able to share the data. So now currently what data is going on in the sense regarding towards this particular topic. So here I'm just changing the slides, and the same thing you are also able to view in your mobile or laptop, whatever you are seeing. So that is another mode of communication. And one of the highlighted communication which is currently available, as well as it is not outdated. So according to this particular function, we can say it as Bluetooth. That also play a major role over there. So within that particular Bluetooth, nowadays we are using to transfer the music as well as the video streaming, whatever you cast towards your TV or using your Bluetooth headphones, you are able to send the complete audio through Bluetooth itself. So that is also one sort of wireless communication. And one of the newborn wireless communication, whatever we say, there is LoRa, which can be varied from range of 0 to 13 kilometers. So according to that particular 13 kilometers, we will be able to communicate without the help of internet. But the problem is, upon the 13 kilometers, we won't be able to communicate it. But whereas if we use this internet, we will be able to communicate throughout the world. The problem, whatever we will be facing, only the network connection. The full form of Wi-Fi is wireless fidelity. WI for wireless, FI for fidelity. So generally, whenever we work regarding towards the different kind of communications, so Bluetooth, LoRa, ZigBee, radio frequency, so this particular kind of functions only we will be particularly enabling all kind of systems with the help of an embedded system. So that's why only I have started with an intro towards the embedded system over there. So first let us see regarding towards the Bluetooth. So generally the Bluetooth, it is a wireless technology which works based on the UHF radio waves. The bands varies from 2.402 to 2.480 gigahertz. So this particular kind of communications are commonly known as personal area network. So why it is said as personal area network? Because multiple connections cannot be done, and this connection is not a long lasting connection. For example, if you are using your Bluetooth headphones connected towards your phone, even if the headphones is within your body or within that particular range only, you will be able to get some kind of data. Let it be audio, video, anything. But if it changes even that particular slight variation, therefore you won't be able to hear it. Like as many of them will be thinking that let the song play over there, I will carry my headphone with me itself. But within the house, it is not possible. You have to keep your phone within you, and as well as the headphone, or else you won't be able to receive the particular data. So like that kind only, many of them are using their fit bands. So within that fit band, internally they have fixed that Bluetooth. and through that Bluetooth you are able to connect your mobile phone, and with the help of that mobile phone connection, according to the brand whatever you have purchased, you are downloading the app and the entire details has been displayed over there, and from there it is able to connect towards the cloud of the particular brand or organization, and the entire data will be stored, so you will be able to retrieve whenever you require it. So this is the most common application regarding towards the Bluetooth, which will be able to connect towards the multiple systems for multiple kind of functions whatever we see in our real time. Many of them are thinking that Bluetooth is outdated, but Bluetooth is not outdated, especially if you go for this kind of technology systems. So another one common thing is required over there is Internet of Things. So a thing that works with the help of internet for multiple oriented access or multiple operations, which we will be using towards our daily to day life. So towards our life, what and all the functions we are doing, let it be a content hearing or content sharing, nowadays attending the classes or getting the updated newses. So for this kind of systems only we are using this Internet of Things. So with the help of this particular Internet of Things, mostly it is commonly connected towards the all the physical devices. So here the physical devices can be said as the system, mobile, or the fitband, whatever you are connecting towards it. And the interfacing towards the system as well as a mobile, whatever the device which you have, that interfacing is known as the serial communication. So through serial communication only you will be able to send each and every data, and this serial communication protocol, it is highly enabled in all kind of controllers and processors, which is commonly known as the embedded system. And with the help of the VLSI, they are able to centralize all these devices, and it is able to receive in our hands as a miniature device, which is less weight, easily portable, and easily replaceable or serviceable. So here, therefore, this particular cloud computing, cloud plays a major role over here in order to transfer the data and store the data whenever we are interfacing towards the Internet of Things. Because in order to retrieve any of the old data, we will be using this cloud oriented applications only. Especially if those who have experienced with Lenovo watches or Redmi watches, so they might be known how the data is being stored and what are the requirements should we use in order to interface a particular fitband and at the same time working over towards the cloud. So at the same time, two wireless communications will be working over there. So if you have any doubts till this particular slides, you can just post it in the chat box. Yeah, fidelity in the sense enhancement of the communication, or it can also be said as the ranging system, sharing a data. So that is nothing but known as the fidelity. I hope there is no doubt so that we will be carrying on. So these are the commonly used clouds for Internet of Things. So among this cloud, ThingSpeak is a free cloud. So those who are interested towards a particular cloud, they will be able to access it as a researcher or as a student or a professor. So it doesn't mean what kind of designation it is. It is free for everyone. For today's session, we'll be looking for with Blink app. So some of the protocols that and all should be followed, especially if you are using IoT. So those comes under with MQTT, SMTP. And why we have to follow the protocols, in the sense each and every protocol have their standard set of rules. So according to the function or the protocol, whatever we select, we will be able to send or we will be able to receive the particular data. And with the help of this kind of systems, we will be just commonly said as the rules and regulations in a simple words. Especially the MQTT is used to send the message through internet, and whereas SMTP is used to send automatic mail with the help of the internet. So now we will just see some small function regarding towards it. So this SMTP is mostly used to transfer the mail from one person to another. So within this particular protocol, we have three axes over there. One is sender mail server, another one is receiver mail server, and the final one is POP3 as well as IMAP. So these two protocols are commonly known as the post office protocol and internet message access protocol. So with the help of this technical functions only, we will be able to send as well as receive the mail automatically with the help of the alert system. And whatever we are using commonly to send the mail with the help of the Gmail from our browser, for that also we are following the same workflow diagram only. So similar to SMTP protocol, the another protocol is known as the MQTT protocol. And with the help of this MQTT protocol, it is very easy to communicate between machine to machines. And for example, this machine to machine examples itself, now we have within that particular device, whatever we are fixing on our hand, and at the same time towards our mobile. So from that, if you want to upload towards the cloud, definitely we require some MQTT protocol or cloud protocol attached towards it. And based on that particular attachment only, we will be able to upload and store the data within the cloud. So to share between the cloud as well as to share between our neighbors or friends to whom we require. So for that kind of access and all, we will be able to use MQTT protocol system. So how the workflow will be there? So this particular connection, it is known as the applications. So this MQTT broker application, it is commonly used for security surveillance, industrial energy, medical and healthcare, transportation and logistics. The workflow will be the common server will be there. So from that common server, it will be sending the message. So the sending message will be indicated with the help of a topic. So what does this particular topic stand for? It is an identical value. In what way it is identical? In the sense, it is unique, like the mobile number whichever we use. So the mobile number whichever we use till the day or till we cancel the connection, so that particular number belongs to ourselves only. If anyone wants to call us or wants to send message or chat anything, they have to use a 10 digit number. So the same function only this topic also doing, and with the help of the topic, we will be able to send the message simultaneously through internet for multiple number of peoples. The only important connection whatever you require is nothing but internet and a stable receiving or communication app. So if you have any doubt till this, you can just approach. So for now, let us see a demo. So here I have a particular system or the code regarding towards that blinker and ESP8266 Wi-Fi, which is in the mode of NodeMCU. So the NodeMCU, whatever I am using, it belongs to NodeMCU 1.0. I hope everyone is aware of installing the packages. So to install the packages, you can go to the board manager. From that board manager, you are allowed to install all the packages over there. You can type it over here according to the packages whichever you require. And similarly, if you go for the sketch, in library, manage library. So within this particular library, whatever you type, therefore you will be able to see some of the options, and the required option you will be able to work it over there. So just now I am showing a demo in form of Blink, because since I am using the Blink app, I require that particular library file within this system. So here I have already installed. This can be applied for this many kind of functions. So this will be the original kind of Blink app section. So other than that, these are the supporting files. If you require it, you can download it. So according to each and every communication, we will be able to use it as easy as possible. So here I am calling this particular header files, and this will be my authentication ID. So this authentication ID, whenever I register as a new app or new project in my mobile, I would be able to see it. And the authentication ID will be sent to my authorized email through which I have logged towards the system or that particular application. So here you can see. So copy this authentication ID and paste it over here. Provide your character ID and password of your Wi-Fi name and password. Then set the data what and all should be sent. Then provide the function to where it has to be sent, and just provide the common or public calling function. Therefore, we will be able to send the data automatically, and now you have to upload it towards your system. So whenever if you are just connecting towards the system, select the COM port and click on upload button. So please wait till it get uploaded. So here you can see the particular code is being uploaded over there. Therefore, the code has been uploaded. So now let us take our serial monitor. So before taking that particular serial monitor, I have to install the particular app. And from that app, I have to select the required project. So now I will stream this particular phone connection towards my lap. Please wait for a while till it gets connected. Due to network connectivity problem, it is unable to share it towards the screen. Let me try it once again. So therefore the data has been sent. The data is being sent, but due to some network issues, I was not able to receive it. So now I will just try to share the data through camera. I hope everyone is able to see that particular V-band. So through this W-band system only, we will be able to receive through the Blink app device. I hope that everyone has received some sort of idea regarding towards it. If you have any doubts, you can just post it in the chat. We also have started our 1 month internships in embedded systems, artificial intelligence. So those who are interested, you can approach us. So for approaching us, you can contact us in these numbers as well as through our website is also possible. Please like and share our video so that you will also be encouraged in order to work with multiple kind of technologies. So our website is nothing but mantechelearning.com. So in order to make a contact to download your certificates, you can use our websites, and all the upcoming workshops and events are being posted over here. So those who are interested, they can approach us. You can also directly contact towards our WhatsApp with the help of help icon. I hope everyone has enjoyed the session. Once again, I thank KSRM College for providing this wonderful opportunity for the whole ECE department. I hope this particular session, whatever we have taken today, it completely supports in multiple ways, especially for electronics and communication, as well as for biomedical applications. So if you have any doubts or queries, you can just put it in the chat box. Therefore, I will be able to solve it. And I thank all the participants for their valuable comments. So we will be seeing you soon as possible with a new technology. So till then, bye to all. Be safe. Thank you all.